Dr. Azra Raza is a professor of medicine and director of the MPS Center at Columbia University. She is also one of the leaders in the field of cancer research. A few of her awards include the Hope Award in Cancer Research, Woman of the Year Award from Safari, Pakistan, Woman of the Year Award from Azra, and the first Lifetime Achievement Award from UPNOW. Dr. Raza has kindly accepted a position on the board of the University Foundation, U.S. Will everyone please give a warm welcome to Dr. Raza.
Thank you very much, Usman. Thank you, Shaukat, Her Excellency, Aisha Farooqi, the mayor, honored guests. Delighted to be here. Zahir ki aankh se na tamasha kare koi. Zahir ki aankh se na tamasha kare koi. Do not try to visualize with your eyesight. Ho dekhna to deedae dil wa kare koi. If you really want to see, you have to open the eyes of your heart. Real virtue, real excellence, they only come when your heart is involved in the project. Hard facts, knowledge, they're wonderful. But without emotions, they're like a jockey without a horse. They're like a bird without flight. I thought I knew a lot about cancer. I had spent, after all, 25 years taking care of cancer patients. But it wasn't until my own husband got leukemia, the very disease we were trying to cure, that I owned the disease. Because that is when your emotions became involved. And this evening, my friends, is an evening of heartfelt connections. Why do I say this? Let's just begin with the house of Habib. How fortunate we are today that the Honorable Mr. Rafiq Habib is amongst us. And his daughter Marzia, of course, from Toronto. It is thanks to the largesse of the heart of House of Habib that we are all here this evening. In fact, to celebrate their breathtaking generosity in the service of humanity. This family has the honor of establishing the first liberal arts university which can compete with any Ivy League institution in the US. And speaking about the House of Habib, when I was thinking about it, I remembered a little story about Mr. Jinnah. In the early 1940s, before the partition, Mr. Jinnah was addressing a crowd of about 10,000 people in Agra. Amongst those 10,000, maybe there were 500 who had some passing knowledge of English, and maybe 50 of them really understood the language well. Mr. Jinnah spoke in the most pristine, chaste English. And the entire crowd of 10,000 people sat there hypnotized, mesmerized, cheering him on. The great Mushtaq Ahmed Yusufi was in the crowd. Afterwards, he stopped one of the members of the audience who obviously hadn't understood a word in English. And he asked the guy, You did not understand anything Mr. Jinnah was saying. How is it that you were so hypnotized and so supportive of him? And you know what the man said? The man said, yes, it's true. I didn't understand a word what Mr. Jinnah said. But I have full confidence that every word he said was for my good, my benefit. This is the confidence that a true leader inspires in its people. That even if you don't understand what he's saying, there is that wonderful 100% guarantee. And this is the secret of the house of Habib. If the name Habib appears behind any cause, we as Pakistanis are 100% sure that it is for our good. It is for the good of all of humanity. We congratulate Rafiq and Ali Habib, Jamila and Manize Habib, the whole extended Habib, House of Habib. Thank you for carrying forth your family's long tradition of giving with such magnanimity, thoughtfulness, such vision. With the creation of Habib University, you have carried the custom of philanthropy to a loftier level. And we as the audience are truly honored to be a part of this endeavor with you. And you could not have done better than select one Sayyid Wasif Rizvi to lead the charge. Wasif possesses one virtue that I truly admire about men, which women don't really have that much of. It's a very unique manly virtue. Men know how to be slaves. Madam ki daant sun ke mulazim pukar utha, naukar hoon aapka, koi shohar nahi hoon main. Really true. The line said, the servant protested to the madam who was scolding him, saying, listen, I'm your servant, not your husband. Don't talk like that. It's true. If men become impassioned about something, that's it. That is it. They will give up everything in pursuit of that amazing object of desire, whether it is for a beloved or it is for work. That's it. Women, we can't do it because we always think about children first. Even when we don't have children, women are hardwired to think of everybody else before themselves. But men have no such problem. They only think of themselves. So they know. And this is Wasif's greatest virtue. Nazare ko to jumbishe mishga bhi bar hai. Once your eyesight is attached to your object of desire, then even the blinking of an eye is very annoying. Nazare ko to jumbishe mishga bhi bar hai. Nargis ki aankh se tujhe dekha kare koi. Only with the eye of the flower narcissus one should look at the beloved, because it never blinks. And this is Wasif's great love for the university. Every sulcus and gyrus in his brain, every fiber in this body, every waking, thinking moment in Wasif's life is dedicated to his love, passion, his shauk for Habib University. Arzo sama kaha teri busat ko pa sake, mera hi dil hai wo ke jahan tu sama sake. Aur vehdat mein teri harf dui ka na a sake, vehdat mein teri harf dui ka na a sake, aina kya majal tujhe muh dikha sake. And this sheer specially for Wasif, qasid nahi ye kaam tera apni raah le. Because messages could only be brought by messengers in those days. What is the poet saying? Qasid नहीं ये काम तेरा अपनी राह ले उसका प्याम दिल के सिवा कौन ला सके. एंड दिस इज ट्रूली वासिफ्स मैसेज. इट कम्स फ्रॉम हिज हार्ट. सो आई हैव टू एडमिट टू यू दैट व्हेन आई वाज अप्रोच्ड टू जॉइन द बोर्ड आई हैड मेनी रीजंस टू डिथर एंड फाइंड एक्सक्यूजेस फॉर बीइंग बिजी एंड नॉट बीइंग एबल टू डू इट. Until they let Wasif loose on me. We made a date in New York to meet at the fancy Baccarat Hotel opposite MoMA. As soon as I walked him, he attacked me emotionally. And within 10 minutes, for some reason, I was crying and saying, yes, yes, I'll be with you. And I followed the advice of Khumar Barabankwi, who says, Aklo dil, apni apni kahe jab khumar. Because your mind is telling you something practical. Don't do it. You have no time. But then your heart is now being pulled. Aklo dil apni apni kahe jab khumar, akal ki suniye dil ka kaha kijiye. So here I am because of Wasif's heartfelt message. And in fact, you are all in this room here because of the heart-to-heart connection brought about by Wasif. My friends, this evening, this moment, we are all part of history being made. We should be genuinely proud and honored to be participating in this moment. We are gathered to witness, to celebrate, and to cheer the dazzling Dhananis who have stepped forward to join forces with the House of Habib in the service of this incredible cause. Let us stand and applaud this family. May this family thrive and blossom and grow and continue to promote such deeply humanitarian causes. May the Dhanani name forever become synonymous with giving, with generosity, kindness and philanthropy, goodness in all its gestures, in all its nuances and traditions. Shobhai and Nadia, all of the great extended Dhanani clan, please accept our profound, deepest gratitude and appreciation for what you have done tonight. Fantastic. Congratulations, Mubarak. Habib University now. So what makes this cause of Habib University so vital, so terribly needed, so timely? Let me start by telling you a little story. I was in Islamabad in February, but where is Dilshad? The first thing I want to read is for Dilshad. So last night I had the good fortune to be invited by Dhananis for dinner with the extended clan along with Wasif. And Dilshad asked me, so Azra, do you know any of the funny poetry? So I'm just going to recite one thing for Dilshad today because she asked me for it. You see, in Urdu, one word can change the whole meaning. So, Qurban jao unke lisani shaur ke. Lisani shaur, linguistic sensibility. Qurban jao unke lisani shaur ke. Mafhoom ek lafz ka jo bhi samajh liya. Anwar mere watan ke jawanon ne aaj kal. इकबाल की खुदी को भी सेल्फी समझ लिया. सो दिस फेब्रुअरी आई वाज द कीनोट स्पीकर फॉर द लाहौर लिटरेरी फेस्टिवल. आई वाज स्टेइंग विद माय फ्रेंड्स एंड दे सेंट अ ड्राइवर टू पिक मी अप. परफेक्टली नॉर्मल ऑर्डिनरी लुकिंग ड्राइवर इन अ येलो शलवार कमीज कम्स टू पिक मी अप. एज वी आर ड्राइविंग अलोंग मॉल रोड वी गेट स्टक इन ट्रैफिक सो वी हैव प्लेंटी ऑफ टाइम. He said to me, so I've heard you are speaking at the literary festival. I said, yes. He says, what are you going to say? I said, well, actually, I'm going to tell the story of Mahmood and Ayaz because Ayaz became the first Muslim governor of Lahore. and basically converted it from ruins into the thriving metropolis that Lahore became 1,000 years ago. And he was a slave. So he said, give me an example of his cleverness. I said, well, Mahmud the king once asked his slave Ayaz, here's my ring, write something on it which will make me sad when I'm happy and happy when I'm sad. And without blinking an eyelid, Ayaz wrote on it, this too shall pass. So if you're sad, this too shall pass, and you become happy and vice versa. The driver was not impressed. He looked at me and said, that's all? Hamare Punjab mein to isse behtar kaha hua hai. They have said it better in Punjabi. I said, really? What did they say? He said, well, he says, dushman mare khushi na kariye, sajna bhi mar jana hai. This too shall pass. And then he said to me, and Begum Sahab, you know, I will tell you my guiding principle. Now this is a driver. This is what is so ravishing about our society and our culture. You see, the West has very distinct separation between Athens and Jerusalem. Athens represents reason, Jerusalem represents spirituality. We don't make such distinctions. We have a seamless connection between our Athens and our Jerusalem, our hearts and our minds. And we are guided for it by all our great writers, leaders, poets. And you can be sitting in a taxi in Pakistan, and the driver will be playing a ghazal. But the amazing thing is, at the right moment, he is going to say, wah. And that completely ravishes me on the spot. This driver said to me, my guiding principle in life is, tamanna darde dil ki ho, to kar khidmat faqeeron ki. If you want to develop that anguish, that sensitivity to feel the pain of others, then what do you have to do? Tamanna darde dil ki ho, to kar khidmat faqeeron ki. Then you have to go and sit at the threshold of faqeers, destitutes. Nahi milta ye gohar badshahon ke khazino mein. You don't find such pearls in the treasure houses of emperors and kings. You find them at the threshold of the Sufis, the faqeers. So what is this faqiri that he is talking about? Hussein bin Ali's son asked him a question once, Baba, what is the meaning of faqr, faqiri? The Imam writes a book on it, Miratul Arifin. If you haven't read this book by Hussein bin Ali, you can order it, you can get it in 24 hours, and you must read it. The Imam describes in the entire book, it's a beautiful book, but he describes the word faqr as meaning impoverished, but impoverished in a way that you have no needs except one, the need for a spiritual connection to the eternal mystery. That is the only need which will help us overcome the anguish which we suffer from because of the enigma of incompletion. Forever we are seeking things. You can have all the money in the world, you can have everything, all the health, all the beauty, and yet you will still be seeking. What are we seeking? What is that journey into irresolution? And that is the faqr that he is talking about. Somebody asked Imam Ali once, so you are always talking about a God. Have you ever seen your God? He goes, yes, I have. He goes, really? Describe him for us. And Ali said, well, I have seen him not with my eyesight, but with my insight. And that is what faqr is. How do you develop this insight? It doesn't come from acquiring a skill like becoming a doctor or a lawyer or a businessman. It comes through deep and profound meditation into the question of what makes us all human. Our sorrows, our shared joys, the source of our insecurities, In fact, the search for the eternal mystery, what we call the israr-e-azal, jab ke tujh bin nahi koi maujood, phir ye hangama hai, khuda kya hai? Ye pari chehra log kaise hain? Ghamzao, ishwao, ada kya hai? Sabzao, gul kahan se aaye hain? Abr kya cheez hai? Hawa kya hai? Shikne zulfe ambari kyun hai? Nigahe chashma surma sa kya hai? Only Ghalib can have the audacity to stand there and ask these questions. Jab ke tujh bin nahi koi maujood, phir ye hangama hai, khuda kya hai? And this is what a liberal arts education is supposed to do. It's supposed to provide you with the tools to search deeper into your own souls, to acquire the skills to emulate the great and noble characteristics of the insan-e-kamil. This is the education we need to change ourselves for the better and to change our world for the better. This is what helps us know ourselves better, to understand how we contribute to suffering in our own lives and to suffering in the lives of others as well. This is what provides real enlightenment and real emancipation, because then you will understand that no Iqbal is ever going to write koi karma se toota, koi badguma haram se, ke ameer karma mein nahi khue dil nawazi. No, we will produce leaders who have been schooled in this liberal education, who will be better leaders, who are going to stand up and say, auron ka hai payam aur, mera payam aur hai. Ishq ke dard mand ka tarze kalam aur hai. I am standing here to applaud the great work of the House of Habib. I congratulate the amazing Dhanani family for their generosity and their deeper appreciation of this grand mission. I salute Wasif Rizvi for his fabulous superhuman efforts in steering the university with such zest, enthusiasm, wisdom, vision, vigor, courage, and absolute total commitment and dedication. And finally, I end with a message for all of you today. This is a historic day. It is a monumental occasion. Let us stand up and do our part now. And what is our part? Let's not be afraid to take risks. Kuch log tumhe samjhayenge, wo tumko khauf dilayenge. Kuch log tumhe samjhayenge, wo tumko khauf dilayenge. Jo hai wo bhi kho sakta hai. Is raah mein rehzan hai itne robbers, is raah mein rehzan hai itne, kuch aur yahan ho sakta hai. Are kuch aur to aksar hota hai. कुछ लोग तुम्हें समझाएंगे वो तुमको खौफ दिलाएंगे जो है वो भी खो सकता है इस राह में रहजन है इतने कुछ और यहां हो सकता है कुछ और तो अक्सर होता है पर तुम जिस लम्हे में जिंदा हो ये लम्हा तुमसे जिंदा है तुम जिस लम्हे में जिंदा हो ये लम्हा तुमसे जिंदा है ये वक्त नहीं फिर आएगा तुम अपनी करनी कर गुजरो जो होगा देखा जाएगा थैंक यू सो मच थैंक यू थैंक यू थैंक यू थैंक यू शॉकर थैंक यू गेट मी डाउन थैंक यू
सो वंडरफुल गुड
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Live kiya hai.
Wow. Thank you for those wonderful words, Dr. Raza. Truly amazing.